Hey, I'm Michael.
And I'm Paul.
Every day, we help entrepreneurs achieve their goals and grow their businesses.
That's right, but before we started helping others, we were new business owners ourselves.
We know how scary that first step into a new business can be, but we also know that every step into the unknown is an opportunity for innovation and success.
That's why we're setting out, as crazy as it might be, to start a business from scratch and bring it to profit within the next 60 days.
So follow along with us where the risks are real.
Failure is an option.
And even we don't know what's going to happen next.
This is 60 Day Startup.
It is day one of 60 Day Startup. Wish us luck.
All right, so how are we going to do this?
You and I have been involved in enough businesses now that I think we both know that the beginning of every good business is a problem to solve.
Sure, absolutely.
So I've been thinking about this for a little bit.
Yeah.
I was doing some reading about some of my own personal heroes.
Okay.
Leonardo da Vinci, Benjamin Franklin, Albert Einstein.
So some of the small players.
Right. When I was reading about them, I found something really interesting, which was they all shared this one unique habit. And I thought to myself, surely this can't be a coincidence. I think that if we helped people develop this habit that these three geniuses shared, they could transform their own lives.
Okay, so a product that would solve the problem of trying to achieve these habits.
Right.
So something tells me this sounds like a physical product, if I'm not incorrect.
Yeah, so it's gonna be a physical product, which you know means that we're gonna have to design and manufacture it and actually ship it to people.
Which is great because we have absolutely zero experience with physical products.
Right.
But the good news is that we are wanting to show people that when you step into the unknown, that's when you have an opportunity to innovate.
I like it. Well, let's figure out how to do it.
All right.
All right, so you have a product idea. It's a physical product, right?
Right.
I imagine you put together a rough offer bridge of what this could be.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So an offer bridge is a tool we use in the agency that really helps our clients think through a solution that meets their customers' need. You always start with the need, because if you start with the product itself, it might not be the right fit for the need. So the offer bridge brings you all the way from what is the pain point that I'm solving for, to the development of the product, finding your market or your niche, and all the way to finding the right message that it takes to sell the product.
Absolutely, and to your point, it all starts all the way back at what is the problem we're solving for here.
Right.
Yeah. So what is the problem we're solving for?
Right. Well, it might seem a little bit big,
okay,
but the problem that I think I want to solve for is helping people achieve transformation. There's a lot of people that want to see change in their lives, and there's lots of areas that they want to see this change. So the solution that I think that can help them achieve this is a journal. And before you say, well, hey, there's journals out there, right?
Sure.
So I think the problem with all the journals that are out there is that they're not uniquely built for each person. We know everyone is really different, right?
Totally, yeah.
Vastly different. And I feel like all the products that are out there to help people solve this problem, they just don't go far enough to uniquely tailor the product to that person. So I think that there is a huge advantage for us to create a journal that is uniquely built for each person, that's made out of high quality material that lasts them a long time, and that is modular and refillable in such a way that they can keep using it, they can make it into whatever system they want. If they want structure, they can put as much structure in there as they want. If they want no structure at all, it can just be blank pages.
That's a big one. That would be a big one for me.
Yeah.
I obviously have a lot of journals that I use all the time.
Yeah.
But the hard part is I have different things I do at different times of the day. And sometimes I, you know, have a morning journal and then I'll have something that I do at work. And sometimes I want them to relate. But it's not like I'm going to pull a page out of this and like paste it into this, or I have to write an entire another section in there, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So I want to talk about now the message that we can use to help people understand how big of a deal this is.
And in my opinion, I think this is, if not the most important part of the offer bridge, my favorite part.
Sure, yeah. So we always start with something that we've called false beliefs. Mm-hmm. Whenever you try to present a solution to someone, they're going to either have doubts about themselves. In this case, maybe it's, well, I'm not a writer, or I've tried to pick up a journal to have it before and it just doesn't work for me. Some other doubts that they might have is that this isn't going to transform my life. I just don't believe in the power of the solution.
Sure.
So we need to answer those doubts mm-hmm. with some undeniable truth. And I think that there's a ton of opportunity here to do that. First of all, this journal is built specifically so these people will keep the habit. Mm-hmm. It's not forcing you to be anyone different than you already are.
Sure. And I would say it might be smart for us to still have some variable systems that we suggest.
Absolutely.
But allow those people to like pick and place amongst that system.
So that moves us into our final piece here, the revelation.
Yeah.
And so this is like the big tipping point, right?
Right. The one question, right?
Right. So this is the one question we need our buyers to say yes to in order to get them from that land of stagnation where they have this problem and there's no solution in sight for them, to a land of transformation where they've identified the solution, they've identified that our solution is the right answer for them, and they're ready to take hold of it, okay? So I wrote down that the one question that they need to answer yes to mm-hmm. is a journal that is uniquely fitted to my needs the key to achieve change and transformation in all these areas of my life?
I see that. I like it. I'm scared of it, but
that's good.
That's a good feeling. That's how every business starts, right? Gonna get out of the office a little bit to have a name storm. Can I call it that?
Yeah, sure. We can call it that.
I'm gonna call it a name storm.
Trademark. We need to come up with a name for this journal.
Yeah.
That is memorable.
Yep.
Easy to pronounce, hopefully.
Mm-hmm. What if we could take, you know, what if we got down to like 5 or 10 that we really liked and we could kind of throw them at the public?
Sure.
Like run an advertising campaign to our general, to the demographic that we think might be the first to jump in on something like this.
Okay, well, let's give it a shot.
First, we need some names.
Oh yeah, we do need names, you're right.
For you guys who don't know, Nashville has this great entrepreneurship center that is real easy and cheap to become a member of, and they have awesome resources. You can go through mentorships with people who have been entrepreneurs or are entrepreneurs in your certain field. You also can kind of have access to all the resources that are there, meeting rooms, there's a little cafe, there's all kinds of stuff here. Really great. I hope every major city across the U.S. starts to have them because been instrumental in, I think, launching a bunch of different businesses in this town.
So I pulled up this Google sheet here, mm-hmm. kind of auto-combines a lot of different things so we can quickly view the different sort of permutations of our name. Let's think about nouns that have to do with the product. Obviously, journal, book.
Yep.
I have day down.
Note.
Path.
Sojourn.
Mejourn.me. Youjourn.me.
Book, that book. One journal I really like, but I also think that's taken.
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't think any of the Saga ones work.
Mimimo. What? Is that Mimimo?
Yeah.
Mimimo. I do like One Book.
Yeah.
Like One Book to Rule Them All. And in the darkness, fight.
Oh, Lord. Please help us. Let's see if we can't go ahead and check some of these.
Let's do it. Let's see what's available.
Okay. Let's run with these 5.
Okay.
You feel good about it?
I think it's compelling enough beginning that we will hopefully see one pull out from the pack from a test.
Okay.
Who wants to build an ad campaign?
Let's do it.
Cool.
Let's do it.
At the end of the day, a business is a lot more than a name or an idea. Entrepreneurship is a journey into the unknown, a journey of connection and community and helping out one another. Mark Twain once said, 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things that you didn't do than the things that you did do. So join us on this journey of entrepreneurship over the next 60 days as we explore what lies ahead. We'll see you next week on 60 Day Startup.